We recently had the chance to go to Columbia, South Carolina, and get our first look at Kawasaki's all-new KFX450R. And there we had the opportunity to sit down with Vince Iorio, the product manager, and Kawasaki's factory racer, William Yokley, to get an up-close look at the new machine.
We wanted to create a machine that was equally at home on a motocross track and in the woods. So we had to decide on a width of the machine, which we think is an optimum width. The center of gravity is very low, so it performs equally well for the off-road rider in the woods as it does for a motocross rider on the track. With some established products in the marketplace, we knew that we had to raise the bar. The engine for the KFX450R is derived from the KX450F motocross bike, but there's a lot of differences. Obviously, weight was an issue. Power, fortunately, was not an issue. The engine that we began with produces plenty of power for an ATV. What changed is that we needed to make it more durable, especially in the top end. Of course, EFI, which does not exist on the motocross bike, so that was adapted to this machine. It's our first sport quad with fuel injection. Other things were added, such as reverse gear, for the convenience of the rider, which is a first in our class.
The reverse is like a dream come true because, I mean, nobody's perfect, and whenever we're running the speeds we are, especially in the woods, there's just no way around making a mistake. I mean, sooner or later, everybody makes them, you know, and you know you made a mistake before you ever stop. So when you come screeching to like a halt, you can be gearing down and have your finger on the reverse because it's easy, very accessible right there on the handlebar. I've already used it a couple times in the races. You slide up into a tree, hit the reverse, fly backwards, click it back in first gear, you're gone in 5 seconds, you know. So it's a lot better than used to, you know, when you stop, pull it back or get off and move it over. And it saves so much more time, and it's just comfortable knowing you got it.
Now, along with a great engine and transmission, the KFX450R has an all-aluminum frame.
The development of the aluminum chassis was very important to us because that is the future. Every motocross bike, every top-line motocross bike has an aluminum chassis these days. It's mainly to save weight, but it's also to build in a certain amount of rigidity. It has forgings and castings that are welded together. It has a single box tube front end, which makes the attachment point for the A-arms very close together, resulting in very strong suspension benefits. Longer A-arms up front, more suspension travel, and less wheel camber change. So a lot of positive aspects. The big challenges with aluminum, of course, is that no one had done it before. One of our manufacturing challenges was that all of our welders in our factory in Nebraska are used to welding steel. So one of the big challenges was to train up enough welders to handle the kind of production that we needed. And so with that done, the chassis is the highest performing chassis in the market.
My first impression of the 450, the first time I got on it, was actually out on a motocross track there in Southern California, and I was pretty impressed with it because the way the thing handled stock and everything, the aluminum frame is like super lightweight with the suspension, the geometry and everything, and the way it handled with the stock shocks was better than I ever expected, really. You know, the way the thing jumped, the way it cornered, the way, like, you know, when you're going through the rough stuff, the way you could always correct it if you ever messed up, and it jumped really, you know, really smooth, and you know, the balance felt real good on it. And for a stock motor with an airbox lid and the stock pipe and everything, I was really impressed and pleased more than anything because I knew I was going to be on it this year and took all the stress off of me because I was wondering how the thing was going to perform and all. And it turned out just working awesome and exceeding all my expectations that I had for the thing. And kind of reminded me of the old Lobo chassis at the front end and the way it all worked and the way it felt, you know, it's super lightweight and the quick power. So I was pretty very pleased.
Target customer for this product is the racer, the rider who is at the leading edge of performance, who wants a machine that's very, very easy to adapt to racing. We designed the machine to have a minimal amount of required changes to make it race ready. Just personal suspension settings, maybe tire choices, other components such as grips are all that is necessary for an amateur to take the machine out and race it. So fortunately, we were able to take what is on the market and measure it, look at it very carefully in building this product and determine where to set our benchmarks. And we set them very, very high. So we're very happy that we achieved it. Some of the strongest engineering talent in the company, guys that have been designing ATVs for years and years, were involved in this project, and it was very close to their hearts, and we think that they achieved in positioning this model in the top of the spectrum.
Coming soon, we'll have a complete test of the new KFX 450R.
If you want more information on the products, ATVs, or adventures featured in today's show, make sure you check out our website at atvtv.com.